And we're here with Robin Trower. And Robin, welcome to the show. And absolutely a pleasure to be seeing with you. And welcome to D.C. And how's it going on your latest tour right now?
It's going very well. Very well indeed. We've had great audiences everywhere. And I'm having a lot of fun playing.
Well, you've been on the road for as many years as I can count. How often does it ever get tiring? Does it ever get boring to you?
Traveling can get tiring and boring, but playing is never that. It's always fun. I say always, you know, 99 times out of 100, you always get something out of a show or a gig.
Okay. Now, how exactly, what inspired you to pick up the guitar? You played with the band Poco Herring back in the 70s, which really isn't the kind of style that you've projected later on in your solo career. How'd you get started and everything? How did it all come for up?
Well, when I was about 12 or 11, I was a big Elvis Presley fan, and he played a guitar, so I had to have one for Christmas, and that's how it got going, you know.
Okay, and then from there, you were in the band Poco Herring. Was that your first band that you were in, big professional band? Or
no, the first professional group I had was a band called the Paramounts, which that was the early 60s, and we made a few records, but we weren't that very successful, but Poco Herring was the first really international band I was in.
Okay. Now, what year did you leave Poco Herring to start your solo career?
73, I started. That was my first solo album.
Okay. And that Twice Removed from Yesterday, is that correct?
That's right.
Okay. How many albums to date have you recorded as a solo artist?
I don't know. It's a lot.
It's a lot. Huh?
Yeah, it's, let me see, it's got to be, that's 17 years. It's got to be 15, I would think, 14 or 15.
I know it's quite a few, and I realize, you know, the numerical number is hard to pick up. Now, you have a new album out on Atlantic Records right now. It's called In the Line of Fire, with a new single called Turn the Volume Up, which I feel like it's an old anthem rock tune for any radio station, and you also have a video for it. The video is kind of strange, too, as well. Tell us a little bit about that.
About the video?
Yes.
Well, it is strange. It's a very strange video, but it was completely the idea of the director to do to shoot it on the canals in Venice, and it was fun to do, a lot of fun, because we were outdoors all day and floating around on this raft in the canals, you know, and it's a lovely area to be.
And we're back once again here with Robin Trower. And Robin, after looking at the video, definitely a summertime type video with the sunshine and the water and everything. Now, tell us about, you've been on the road, like we said before, a lot of years. Any outstanding experiences, you know, anything come across?
Well, I did take 5 years off where I didn't tour, because I got sick of touring towards the end of the 70s. And also I wanted to spend some more time with my children. But when I think of great experiences, probably two things come to mind. Was the Isle of Wight Festival I played with Poco Herring. I can't even remember what date that was. That was about 1970, I think, 71. And the other thing is the first time I ever played Bridge of Sighs live, before we'd even recorded it. And I always remember the reaction that we got from playing that the first time in San Francisco, in fact.
Now, that album that you had done, Bridge of Sigh, you said you recorded it earlier and then went out and played it before it was released. That trademark of Jimi Hendrix followed you for a long time when that album came out. Do you think that was justified or unjustified?
I'm not sure whether it really matters, whether it was justified or otherwise. I don't think it really matters. I think all that matters about music is how good it is and how much people like it. I think the rest is just, you know, writer's jargon, really.
Now, what are your future plans right now? I know you're still touring with this current record and all. What do you see for yourself 2 or 3 years down the road now?
Hopefully, I'll still be thinking that I'm improving as a player and enjoying it just as much as I am now. I'd like to have the opportunity maybe to do some movie score music or something like that, as by way of something different. And also I would like to maybe get into writing and producing a bit more for other people, but I'm quite happy to think I'll still be just playing guitar as well, you know.
Okay, can you tell us about your current band members and how long they've been with you?
Well, the main nucleus of the band is myself and Davey Patterson, the vocalist, because we've used quite a varied amount of bass and drums players over the years. But the current lineup is myself, Davey, and Glenn Letch on bass and Dean Johnson on drums.
You look as to any change down the road, you think maybe as if you go into another record or anything like that, or do you want to stick with the same unit?
I'm very happy with this band. In fact, I think it's probably the best live band I've had. I think it's great, and probably will, if I get my own way, use them on the next record. Yeah.
Well, Robin, thanks a lot for being here today here on Rocket, and continued success and good luck to you. You're an outstanding artist.
Thank you very much.
My pleasure to see you.